And you're in a place of separation where God can separate you from the thing that has dragged you down. And you can climb that ladder of success in the kingdom of God. But this poor woman, she didn't know what love was. Do you know that on television and everywhere you're here today, we're naming sins, certain ones, and we're condemning people. God does not condemn people. God condemns the sin that is in people. Another amen or two?
Amen.
I could say that old drunk. He's not an old drunk to God. He's a lost soul that's going to die and be lost. And Jesus went to the cross and he suffered and he bled and he died. He buried and he arose because he was a lost soul to God. Jesus didn't stone him. But this woman was caught in the very act of immorality. And the five self-righteous church deacons want to have a little meeting in the back room and discuss what are we going to do with her. Boy, you know what? Without knowing it, they did exactly the right thing. Huh? Yeah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Somebody's going to bring you to the Lord one of these days, and you never dreamed it happened that way. Somebody's going to try to put you down or something, but God's going to go over top of it all, and you're going to end up in the presence of Jesus.
Amen.
Woo! Hallelujah! Know that? Yeah, they didn't know it, but they did exactly. They'll bring in and get the board together. Well, they did this. Now, I think, well, take her license. And I think, well, I think they ought to be ordering a church. And decent people should be here where I'm at. But you know what? We're all sinners saved by the grace of God. I'm not to heaven yet, are you? If I'm alive tomorrow, I'm going to have a battle with the devil. God sanctified me this day. He'll sanctify me again tomorrow. He said, preacher, what are you talking about? Well, you know, you get sanctified. You don't lay it aside. You still with me? I thank God we're sanctified by what? Not by somebody's yelling and carrying on. Not by what old doctor buddy somebody believed. But we're sanctified by the Word. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Sanctified by the Word. And they brought this poor young lady, however she was, Mary Magdalene, in the presence. See, they did just exactly what God needed had to be done. They brought her into the place of condemnation, but thank God they also brought her into the place of separation.
Amen.
Oh, they wanted to separate her, all right. They set her down in the midst of Jesus. Jesus took his finger and wrote in the dust. I don't know what he wrote, and you don't know what he wrote, and everybody speculated on what he wrote, but I have no idea. But I know whatever it was, it put fear of God in those five men right quick. It set them straight where they stood. Because he looked at this woman and what did he say? You dirty, filthy woman of the street. You are useless to society. You are no good. You never have been any good. And you never will be any good. Is that what Jesus said?
No,
but that's what the five other men were saying. Well, thank God this morning, I'm not saying that to you. If you're here today and you're low in sin, you don't know how to look up, I'm telling you that you're in a day of holiness. You're in a day of separation. You can get separated from that, and Jesus Christ can save you and redeem you because God is not condemning you. He is convicting you.
Yes.
Woo! Hallelujah. I've heard people say somebody did something. Well, I kind of condemn him for that. Listen, it's not your job to condemn anybody. God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Hey, hallelujah. Amen, somebody. World might be saved. Not lost. They brought her and cast her down roughly in the front of Jesus. Said, stone her. The law says stone her to death. You know, a lot of folks get laws and love mixed up. Hallelujah. Oh, Charles, you're so good this morning. A lot of folk are getting the law and the love mixed up. If we'd been under the law, all of you in here would be dead. And I would too. But thank God we were under the law of love and the law of grace. We're here today and we're saved. We're redeemed, hallelujah, by the blood of Jesus Christ, because we came to the place of separation. Oh, give God some praise in this place this morning. He's still the King. He's still on the throne. He's still the Master. Hallelujah. He's still the Savior. He's still the healer. He's still the blesser. Woo! Glory to God. He's still the life changer. His name is Jesus. I'm not ashamed of that name. Might be the last name I ever say someday. They might whack my head off right after I get the words out. But thank God, let me tell you something. If they do, God will catch it and put a crown on it before it hits the ground. Tonight worrying about Issus. Oh, hallelujah. I'm at the place of separation, thank God. Pretty close to it. Old as I am, I'm thinking about that place of separation. I'm going to leave here. I'm going home be with the Lord. Well, going to close. We got this bunch of people standing around. Well, now, I just don't think we ought to let her sing. Do you ever think maybe if you let somebody could sing real good, get up and sing a song in your church that, you know, they're a good person, but they need the Lord, that might encourage them and help them to get saved? Did you ever hear this kind of preaching before? Huh? Oh, now we got to be careful now. We got to be careful of what we do. We got to be careful. If they come, I hope they sit in the back. Well, they ain't got a chance to sit in the back, because that's where all the Christians are sitting. Just kidding, Billy. Just kidding. I'm going to get this poor woman saved, and then we'll go home. But I want to tell you something. When they brought her and set her down in the feet of Jesus, they brought her to the place of glory. No higher state of glory could she have been in. No greater place of comfort and joy. No greater man on earth could they set her at the feet of, but they didn't know it. Go out, church. Bring in the dope addicts. Bring in the drunks. Bring in the prostitutes. Hallelujah. Fill this place up with them. You all stand outside. Let me preach to them. And when they get getting saved, I'll tell them to come in and again, we'll pray with them. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Get that ring of perfection out of the flesh. We're only perfect because Jesus Christ is in within us. Take Jesus out, and I've become Al Capone the next day. Maybe even John Dillinger. But with Jesus Christ, thank God I've been to the place of glory, the place of separation.